No Man's Sky has lifted itself from one of the decade's most disappointing releases into one of the best space exploration games on the market. Today, we're reviewing the game's latest update, Expeditions. Hello, we're the Bullet Sponges, and we are back with another Play or Pass, where we jump into co-op and multiplayer games and give you our thoughts on whether they're worth playing or not worth your time. And if you feel like joining myself and Nex for more co-op reviews and Let's Plays, feel free to subscribe and sit back each week as we review and play through all sorts of different titles. No Man's Sky released in 2016 as an overpromised shell of a game. And as someone who pre-ordered the game back then, it was like waking up on Christmas morning to see a PlayStation boxed up and ready to go. Only then to find out that the nice attractive packaging didn't really have anything in it. Cheers, Sean. However, to their credit, Hello Games owned their mistakes. They listened to the players' feedback and got back to work, releasing multiple free content updates that improved planet variety, add missions, ships, base building, exocraft, and a whole bunch of other content that took their empty world and filled it with things to do. Not only that, but you can now do it with your friends. And the latest update, Expeditions, helps to target exactly that. Expeditions starts players off from a fixed point in the universe, and sends you on your way to complete various milestones and explore the universe surrounded by other players doing the same thing. Within this, missions have been reworked, weekend events have been added, and there's a time limit in which you can complete all of these different milestones. After which, your expedition game save will be converted into a normal game to continue your adventure. No Man's Sky has been around for a number of years now, but with all of the content drops and updates making the game better and better as years go by, we decided to jump in 2021 to let you know if this game is a play or a pass.
We'd be surprised if you weren't already familiar with the redemption story that had reignited hope after undelivered promises, but this empty box seemed to turn into the gift that keeps on giving. Expeditions aims to build on the vast expanse of the normal No Man's Sky game, but plays as a sort of seasonal mode that runs for a limited time, similar to the season modes that you might find in Diablo 3 and Path of Exile, offering exclusive rewards like a golden ship or a new lightweight jetpack. At its core, the premise has you doing a lot of gathering different materials, maintaining oxygen supply and environmental hazard protection, building useful items and upgrades, and exploring the universe with the goal ultimately to get you to the center. But Expeditions adds another layer, often welcomed in huge sandboxes such as this, in the form of phases. These phases comprise a number of milestones, each one a challenge or experience that rewards some really decent items, and completing a phase will unlock unique rewards exclusive to that expedition. Playing with friends has been made incredibly easy, something that wasn't so streamlined in older versions of the game. We were playing with and getting in each other's way within moments of jumping in.
Did you just run into my laser beam?
I think your laser beam ran into me.
I don't think that happened.
Equipped with a standard multi-tool that can be changed and upgraded, you have a mining beam to extract things, a terrain manipulator that gathers and just blasts the environment, scanner to discover resources such as this hugelite, and a blast weapon, not to be used on these things if you value your time, who are basically the universe's police that will chase you around at severity based on your wanted level, similar to GTA's system. So the higher your wanted level, the more dangerous enemies you need to deal with until you run away and hide. For some reason, you don't get to initially customize your character, but strangely, they got mine pretty accurate. So accurate, in fact, I decided to turn my webcam off just in case. There's lots of flexibility, however, to customize your character once you're in game. I think I had 5 races to choose from, and plenty of colors and preset options too. Movement is pleasurable and has just enough floatiness to hop over things with ease. The interface looks really well polished and may seem a bit overwhelming due to the sheer amount of things you can do at first, but once learnt, it kind of becomes second nature. An initial highlight from Expeditions for Bias was the new luxury of seeing people coming and going, as well as coming across player-made bases. This one with the intention of helping out players that came across it by automatically farming resources that anyone could help themselves to. As Bias mentioned, he was here since the beginning, teaching myself, the newbie, little tips like jetpacking straight after meleeing to travel faster, and saving regularly to avoid losing progress if you crashed. Because of this, I can't comment too well on whether you're taught the basics enough. I had a lot of questions, but it seemed to be part of the experience to learn how things work the hard way. For example, weather conditions on planets can go from nothing to extreme in the blink of an eye. Once you get caught far from a building or your ship, you'll know not to do that again. Your exosuit is what provides your personal inventory, protection against hostile natural environments, life support, and your jetpack, with each aspect being customizable and upgradable through a number of in-game means. Most upgrades in this game come in various grades, from C up to S class, providing increasing bonuses. Once you fix up your starship, you get to explore the rest of the star system, of which there are so many procedurally generated star systems that most will never be visited in the game's lifetime. The variety of planets we experienced was insane, really imaginative creatures and environments that boasted specific resources and climates. Starships have their own inventory and upgrade possibilities too, and come in six types: shuttle, fighter, hauler, explorer, exotic, and living ship. Flying the ships are relatively straightforward control-wise, with third and first person modes. I personally found third person a lot easier to use, and controls for landing and docking in space stations is no hassle at all. A space station exists in most star systems as a means of trading, buying new ships, changing appearance, and is the main hub for missions, something that was overhauled in the Expedition update. When you do choose to hunker down for a while on a planet, you get a really nice building interface, where placing flooring won't be obstructed by the environment. Each thing you build also snaps into place, so you don't have uneven placement. Inside, you are safe from the harsh planetary environments and can build a number of useful things, like teleporters to quickly access space stations and other players' bases, save points, because for some reason you have to save, and storage containers for extra storage. Other than losing progress due to crashing and not saving, yet the ore I just mined 2 minutes earlier was still missing from the planet, and having the strange issue of not being able to get into the space station once, things were relatively fault-free. Well, that's a brief overview of what you might expect if you choose to play, and we've only just scratched the surface. If it seems like your type of game and exclusive unlocks are super appealing, there is still time to get in on this current expedition and unlock some of them yourself. Unlocking all of them for that juicy golden starship, however? Well, we're not there just yet, so you might have to see for yourself.
No Man's Sky seems to have become one of the best space exploration games on the market, and Hello Games have put in a massive amount of work to get it to where it is today. The latest Expeditions update made partying up and finding each other almost instant, and the milestones, rewards, and missions provide a structured framework to help new players learn the game. And for veteran players, the addition of milestones gives you that feeling of achievement, which has been missing in the past. This new structure in the ease of cooperative play helped give us a feeling that we are working together towards the same goal, where previously the co-op gameplay felt a bit directionless. Graphically, the game has a nice, simple art style, which helps create a pleasing ambience, but sometimes it can feel a bit too simplistic. For me, this is most noticeable in the space station interiors, and the fact that some of the ship models look a bit like they're made from Lego. The gameplay itself feels pretty smooth, and crafting, building, flying, and exploring all felt quite intuitive to us and well thought out. The building in particular had a great feel to it, and I can definitely see myself going back into the game and creating a nice snug little base on a random planet. Overall, we gave No Man's Sky 4 out of 5. And if you're still a bit skeptical because of the dodgy initial release, I personally think it's safe to say that Hello Games have taken their mistakes in their stride, and over the years have turned their disappointing mess into a great space exploration game. Let us know in the comments what you think of the game or whether or not you agree with our review. Feel free to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. We're the Bullet Sponges, and we will see you in the next one.